In this video, we're going to look at the connections within a ceiling rose in a lighting circuit in a domestic dwelling. This will link to other videos that I've done on lighting circuits. Also, the circuit has been safely isolated, locked off and proved dead, of which I've done a separate video on that in the past. We're just going to look at the connections and how they're terminated within the ceiling rose in this video presentation. So let's take off the ceiling rose cover and look at the cables and connections within a ceiling rose in a domestic dwelling. We've actually got three twin and CPC cables, and they're 1 mm² in this case for a lighting circuit. And we've got the following terminations: a separate block of two here, switching line, a center block of three, which is loop, and an end block here of three, which is neutral. So we've got three twin and CPC cables. We've got the supply coming in. So let's say this one here, this brown conductor here and this blue neutral here would bring a permanent line in and the neutral connection into this ceiling rose. The permanent line is connected in the loop section here and the neutral in this block of three plasters neutral. We've then got a cable which is a permanent line and a neutral going out to the next room. So again, permanent line out the loop and a neutral out the neutral block. We've also got another twin and CPC cable, one that we'd probably use as twin brown in the classroom, which takes again from the center loop a permanent line connection down to the switch. And when it returns here in the switching line section, it is actually blue identified with brown sleeving. It isn't a neutral, it's a switching line conductor to turn on the light itself. The permanent lines in the center, in the loop, the feed goes down to the switch. The switch returns as a switching line against the side of the lamp. The other side of the lamp is connected to neutral in order that we can turn it on and off from the switching line, and a neutral is a return path. The three CPCs, one from each of the twin and CPC cables, are connected in the earth terminal within the ceiling rose itself. The earth terminal is there in case the fitting is changed for an exposed conductive part, in which case the CPC would be needed. Now let's have a look in another ceiling rose. So this time we only have two 1 mm² twin and CPC cables coming into this fitting. The reason for that, it is the final point on the radial lighting circuit and only has the supply coming in. It doesn't go off to another room. We still have the same arrangements of a set of two for switching line. So let a set of two connections here for switching line, a set of three connections for the permanent line in the looping terminal, and three connections here for the neutral to be connected. So the supply comes in, permanent line comes into loop, along with the neutral to the neutral block. A permanent line goes down to the switch and returns on not a neutral connection. It is blue, but identified with brown sleeving, and is a switching line conductor, and is connected in the switching line connection here of two. The CPCs are both secured within the earth terminal in case it's changed for an exposed conductive part. So we looked at two different lighting points on the lighting circuit. We looked at one part way through the circuit where the supply came into the ceiling rose and then the supply was taken out to another room. And then we finished off by looking at one at the end of the radial circuit where the supply only came in and didn't continue on to any other part of the circuit. It actually finished at that point, so therefore was the furthest point in the radial circuit. We also got to see that twin brown wasn't being used, as we're using twin brown in my workshop, that they actually used twin and CPC. It wasn't a blue neutral returning from the switch, it was actually a switching line, and we can see how the electrician in this installation identified that with brown sleeving. This, along with other videos on lighting circuits, are where our knowledge is going to next. We're looking to extend that knowledge in the first 10 weeks of our learning. I hope this video has been some help.